Good morning students, let us start application number 2 of Bio-Savart law. In this we have to find magnetic field B at the axis of circular coil. Now firstly let us understand the meaning of axis. A circular coil means this type of coil in which current is flowing, that is given. Now, this is the center of the coil. Here we have already calculated the magnetic field. Now, what is the meaning of axis? That is the line which is passing through the center of the coil and perpendicular to plane of the coil. So, the plane of the coil is this plane, the coinciding with the plane of the board. So what is the axis? That is this thing. Okay, so axis means the line which is passing through the center and perpendicular to the coil. Now we can understand it with the help of this bangle. Students, suppose this is the circular coil. Now what is the meaning of the axis? So one line which is passing through it, through its center, and perpendicular to its plane. Okay, we can also show the side view of this coil like this. Okay, this is the side view of the coil. Now our target is to find the magnetic field at some point. Suppose at this point, due to this coil, we have to find the magnetic field. So we are also going to draw the side view of the coil only. This will help us to understand the three-dimensional parameters. So let's start. Now we need the side view of the coil. So let us start drawing. Suppose this is the side view of a circular coil. It is looking oval in shape because we are seeing it from side. Now this is the line which is passing through its center and perpendicular to its plane. So this is called the axis. Okay, this is called the axis. Suppose at this axis some point P we are taking, and here we have to find the magnetic field B here. So this coil is carrying the current I, and due to this I, that means due to this current carrying coil, we have to find magnetic field B here. First of all, let us name some datas. Suppose from the center of the coil, the point's distance is x and this radius of the coil is A. So A radius, x is this distance. Now we will find this magnetic field using the help of Bio-Savart law. You know that the Bio-Savart law formula for the magnetic field is dB equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi I dl sine theta upon r square. So Bio-Savart law says that first of all we have to assume dl, length element, in that system. Then we find dB, and after that we integrate this dB so that we get the total field. So let's start taking the length elements in this coil. Current is at the circumference. So we will take the length element also at the circumference only. Now, first of all, since this coil is having a symmetry, just above the axis some part of coil is appearing and just below the axis some part of the coil is appearing. So we will take one length element above and one length element below. Let us call it DL1 and DL2, both are of equal length. Okay, DL1 and DL2 are actually, you can say, DL only. Now what is our target? Due to this first DL1, we have to find magnetic field here. So we need to join it with the point, and this distance we will call now R. And already you can see that R, A and X are related in the Pythagoras theorem. So we can write r equal to root of a square plus x square by Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so x a, so this is a square plus x square root, we will call it this distance r. Now due to this dl1, the magnitude of db here we have to find out. Okay, so let us call it db1. Due to dl1, db1 we have to find out. So we will be applying the Biot-Savart law formula. db1 is equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi. I is the current, which is given I. dl is the length of this element. And sine theta is required and r square is required. R square is this distance from dl to p, to the point p. So r square is written. Now main thing is to understand here this sine theta. What is the theta between dl and the line joining? For that you need to see this circular coil. See students, this is the circular coil and this white thing, suppose it is dl element, which is assumed. So dl is horizontal and its direction is considered with the help of the current direction. Now suppose I am taking in the diagram that current is coming out. Okay, current is coming out. So dl is this horizontal thing. This is dl. Okay, and then the point is at the center here somewhere. So you can see the side view. Point is here somewhere. And this pink pen is the R. Green pen is DL. And between these two pens only the angle theta we have to find out. So you see now, this way the angle is appearing 90 degree. Why? Because you see, this green pen is DL and this pink pen is the distance R. Distance R means from DL to the point P. So pink pen is R and DL is this green pen. So again you can see DL and the angle between this R distance. This angle you can see that it is 90 degree. That's why we will write theta 90 degree in the formula. So here we have 90 degree. Okay, db1 magnitude we have solved like this. Now we have to write db2, that means due to the second length element what is the db2 here? So we need to join it again. Okay, due to the second length element, what is the small magnetic field? We will call it db2. Now db2 is also found out by the same formula. So it is actually the same formula. So mu 0 upon 4 pi I dl. Here also the length of the dl2 is same as first element. Again sine 90 will appear here. And r square distance is also the same. Because this is a and this is x. So this will come same as this distance. That's why db1 and db2 are appearing same. So we can write that the magnitude of db1 and db2, magnitudes, are same. We can call it db now. Now, next thing is that we have to understand the direction of db1 and db2, that we will find out using right-hand thumb rule. Let us apply right-hand thumb rule for finding the direction of db1 and db2. So for that students, you have to see this bangle. See, this white color is dl. Its direction is always considered in the direction of the current. I have taken current outwards on the upper side. Current outwards. So current is going. So I'll show you. So current is moving like this. एंड देन एट द एंड इट इज गोइंग इन. सो करंट डायरेक्शन इज दिस वे. ओके, सो वॉट वी हैव टू डू नाउ, इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ करंट वी हैव टू होल्ड आर राइट हैंड थंब. वेयर देन द फिंगर्स आर कर्लिंग दैट वी हैव टू सी फॉर डायरेक्शन ऑफ DB1. ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट लेंथ एलिमेंट DL1 इन द डायग्राम DL1, इट्स करंट इज हियर, द करंट इज कमिंग आउट ऑफ द बोर्ड एंड हियर इन द बोर्ड. सो लेट अस ट्राई नाउ, राइट हैंड थंब रूल लगाना है करंट को थंब के डायरेक्शन में. ओके, करंट एंड थंब डायरेक्शन सेम एंड फिंगर्स आर कर्लिंग वेयर. सो लेट सी नाउ, व्हेन आई विल होल्ड दिस वायर देन यू सी थंब इज पॉइंटिंग आउट ऑफ द बोर्ड वेयर द फिंगर्स आर कर्लिंग. सो फिंगर्स कर्लिंग डायरेक्शन इज दिस वे, दिस वे. सो दैट आई एम शोइंग इन द डायग्राम. ओके, इन द सेम मैनर. ओके, आई विल जस्ट रिपीट इट. DL डायरेक्शन इज द करंट डायरेक्शन, करंट इज आउटवर्ड्स, सो थंब शुड बी पॉइंटिंग आउटवर्ड्स. वेयर द फिंगर्स आर कर्लिंग दिस वे, सो दिस इज द डायरेक्शन, दिस लाइन. ओके, फिंगर डायरेक्शन, दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, दैट्स वाई दिस लाइन हैज बीन शोन. नाउ फॉर द लूप विच इज बिलो. ओके, इफ द लूप इज बिलो हियर, इन दिस द करंट इज गोइंग इन. ओके, इन दिस द करंट इज गोइंग इन. सो वी हैव टू नाउ टर्न आर राइट हैंड थंब इनवर्ड्स एंड वी हैव टू सी द कर्लिंग फिंगर्स अराउंड इट. सो वील होल्ड दिस वायर लाइक दिस. यू सी थंब इज गोइंग इन द बोर्ड वेयर द फिंगर्स आर कर्लिंग. सो फिंगर्स आर कर्लिंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन. लेट अस शो इट इन द डायग्राम. सो we will show this diagram, this direction DB2 in the diagram. Clear students? So direction of DB we have found using the right hand thumb rule. RHT means right hand thumb rule. After finding the directions, now we have to solve the resultant. Let us start. Since DB1 and DB2 are two magnetic fields due to two length elements which we have assumed here, and we will take the help of resolution technique to solve resultant. So we need to take two axes for resolution, this vertical axis and this horizontal axis. Okay, now along these two axes, I'll just make it dark. You can see horizontal and vertical axis have been shown. Now to resolve, I need angle somewhere. So suppose I am taking theta angle here. Okay, suppose this coil's angle with at the axis is theta. Then since this line and this line, they are at 90 degree, so this will become 90 minus theta. And always remember, this R line and DB line, they are also at 90 degree. Okay, this R and this DB, they are also at 90 degree total. So if this total angle is 90, this is 90 minus theta, then this will also become theta only. Okay, remember one cross product. The direction of DB is obtained. Direction means I will write cap. Direction of DB is always obtained from here. DL cross R cap. Okay. So R cap means this R line, its direction. Okay. And DL means current direction or DL direction. So meaning is what? DB jo hoga wo hamesha R ke perpendicular hoga. To R yeri aur DB yera, इसलिए ये हमेशा परपेंडिकुलर है. So this angle is 90 minus theta. So this angle is theta. Okay. After that, if we do this practice below also, if this is theta, why this is theta? Because upper part and lower part are symmetrical. So angles will also be the same. Then this angle achieved will be 90 minus theta. So this angle will be theta. Okay. After obtaining these angles, now our target is to resolve DB1 and DB2 into components. Let's start now. Firstly, only solve DB1. यहाँ cos, यहाँ theta component है, तो ये cos component होगा. Theta angle के साथ वाला होता है cos component. दूसरा होता है sin component. Let us do DB1 के लिए. ये आया DB1 cos theta और ये आया DB1 sin theta. Remember, angle के साथ वाला cos. Let us resolve DB2. यहाँ theta है. This will become DB2 cos theta and this will become DB2 sin theta. Okay? After that, now we have resolved DB1 and DB2. Now we have four components with us. 1, 2, 3, 4. Out of these four components, DB1 and DB2 cos thetas are cancelling each other. Why? Because they are opposite and they are equal. You already know that DB1, DB2 are equal only. So these are equal components. Cancelled. Remaining are two components, DB1 sin theta and DB2 sin theta. So students, when we have taken two length elements, due to that, we obtain 2 dB sin theta as resulting. That means effectively for one length element, the resultant is 1 dB sin theta. Okay. So due to one length element in the coil, the resultant is 1 dB sin theta. Now our target was due to whole coil. What is the resultant? So if due to the whole coil or loop, we find the magnetic field B, then it is obtained by integrating. Okay, so due to length element DL, we got dB sin theta as a resultant. DL was the part of the coil, and if we have to use the whole coil, we have to integrate DL. That means we have to integrate dB sin theta. Next is that we will put the values here. So dB value. dB value is this only. Both are dB considered. You can see here. Let us put its value. Mu 0 upon 4 pi I dL R square. Sin 90 was there. Sin 90 is 1. Okay. After that, here sin theta is appearing. So how to get sin theta? So from this upper triangle, you can solve sin theta. Sin theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. In this triangle, the base is this line. Perpendicular is this line. Theta ke samne wala hota hai perpendicular. Aur sabse badi edge hoti hai hypotenuse, which is in front of 90 degree. So let us apply the values. Perpendicular is A and hypotenuse is R. Later we will use this R value also. So this way we have just now substituted the values. After this, we have to solve this integration. Now integration, in the integration we take always the constants out. So here you can see D is written with L. And no other L is appearing in the formula. So except this DL, everything is constant. We will take it out. So mu 0 upon 4 pi I A, 0 upon 4 pi I A upon R cube is out. Integration of DL is remaining. Now only DL means part of circumference. Integration of DL means whole circumference. So what is circumference if radius is A? सो इट विल बिकम 2 पाई ए आंसर. तो इसका आंसर इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ dl का आंसर हुआ 2 पाई ए यानी सर्कमफेरेंस. रिमेनिंग थिंग्स आर सेम. ओके लेट अस पुट r क्यूब वैल्यू ऑल्सो. ओके r इज रूट ऑफ ए स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर. दैट मीन्स ए स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर पावर हाफ. बट वी हैव क्यूब ऑफ r. सो वी विल ऑल्सो मेक इट क्यूब. सो दिस वे इट विल कम ए स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर पावर 3/2. नाउ दिस इज द आंसर विच वी हैव ऑब्टेन्ड फॉर दिस कॉइल. इन दिस कॉइल ओनली वन टर्न वॉज देयर. नाउ सपोज देर आर एन टर्न्स. इन केस इफ द कॉइल इज ऑफ एन टर्न. Then we have to only put an extra n in the formula of B. So mu 0 upon 4 pi n extra written. All the things are same. 2 pi I a square upon a square plus x square power 3/2. You can also find the formula in terms of area of the coil because pi a square is area. So, some of the time in terms of area also we can write the answer. So, remember this formula for the axial magnetic field for the coil. Okay. Now, students, we will do two more things. We have to draw the graph between B and X. And one question is also there. Get magnetic field at the center using axial formula. So for the axis of the coil, magnetic field formula is mu 0 upon 4 pi I 2 pi n I a square upon a square plus x square power 3/2. Suppose using this formula, we have to get magnetic field at the center of coil. So you see, this was the coil and at its axis, magnetic field is already known. B axial. How to find magnetic field at the center? So we have to go to the center. That is for the center x is 0. So everywhere we have to put x 0. Here if it is x is 0 put, then mu 0 upon 4 pi 2 pi ni a square is the same. But here x is 0. In case if for the center we have to find, put x 0. Only a square power 3/2 is remaining. Powers in the powers 2 is getting cancelled. A cube left. A square and a cube. So finally a will be left in the denominator. All other factors are same. So this 2 also we can cancel. And ni. So this is the same formula which we have already derived separately. But certain times it comes in the derivations. Just after the axial derivation, you have to get the answer for center of the coil magnetic field. So this way you are going to solve. When we draw the graph between B and X distance, then you see now for the coil, from the center one line is passing. We can go this side also of the coil or this side also of the coil. And how the magnetic field will vary, that is decided by this formula. If we increase this x distance continuously, that means if we go away from the coil, so increasing x, this is x, we are increasing, then magnetic field is decreasing. Okay, so that's why the graph of the magnetic field is decreasing. Suppose we put minus x also, that means for this side of the coil, if 0 is assumed here, if we put minus x also, but here x square is appearing. So whether we go on the another side of the coil, we will put minus x, but it will be no effect here. It will remain the same because x square is appearing. So whether plus x is put or minus x is put in the formula, same variation we will observe. So yahan bhi coil se dur jane pe b decrease hi hoga. So this way the graph is obtained. This graph will not touch this line, because only at infinite distance B will become zero. Okay, now where the B is maximum, magnetic field is maximum where? At the center of the coil. Okay, so magnetic field is maximum at the center. So draw this graph.